I remember the emptiness, vast and endless. The Azim Steppe, home to countless roaming tribes. A sacred land, watched over by elder gods. Here, we would find Doma's salvation. With the wind at our backs, we walked on, in search of hope, in search of him.
Thank you. Hey. How goes the search? Any luck?
What fortune to meet a friend of the young master!
Well met, Cyrena. If you have an inkling as to the current whereabouts of Lord Hien, we should be most grateful for your assistance.
Oh, please! It is I who should be grateful.
Halt! What is this? I came first, you second! Know you to whom you speak? All people of the steppe should. Or have you fought so much that you have forgotten the fate of your superiors?
Superiors? I spit on your superiority, little prince! Twisted and mad as sand devils your kind are!
Those two don't seem to like each other very much.
Those boys are of the Oronir and Dothal, the two strongest tribes. The children of Azim are destined to rule, so they declare to all who will listen. Their word is law, for now. Grand, flamboyant fighters, but deadly, very deadly. He prances as a horse, as do his brothers after their many recent victories. The Undyne ones, too, are strong, fearless, and vicious. They often reigned in the past. Now they are sorely tested. Ah, the master of the markets. He is Castir. To fight in reunion is forbidden, and to break the peace is to be banished forever. This he says without words, for words are lies to the Castir. They do not speak.
That's interesting. And all these different tribes share the same lands, do they? No wonder it's tense.
I shall look for you on the field at the Nardom. Mark my words!
As shall I! Mayhap I shall take 11 more Dothar heads to make a dozen with yours. I look forward to the day!
The dispute will be settled at the Nardom?
A great battle held on the final day of the Sahan San. During this time, all bonds of hierarchy are broken. All Zela are equal and free to prepare for the fight. The tribe which triumphs in the Nardom rules until the next Sahan San. Which in these lands is now.
Ah, so that is what they call the custom. I presume your tribe will also be taking part?
Not all seek the Dawn Throne. Some are satisfied with their lot. Others, like the Castir, have reason to remain neutral. The Mol are lambs among wolves. Long were we content to remain apart and live quietly, but... Never mind that. You seek Hien, yes? I know where he may be.
Thank you.
Akami are merciful! My Lord Hien, I see you are alive and well.
Ah, you are come sooner than expected. So, my blade or my head, which would you have of me?
The people of Yansha remain loyal to Doma. I have seen the fire in their eyes. They are ready to rise up and fight. The time is ripe, my lord. Return with us, blade in hand, and lead Doma to freedom.
Naught less than liberty will suffice, then. A pity. It will prove far more difficult to deliver than my head. But if my people wish to pursue an impossible dream, then who am I to deny them? Yugiri, Gosetsu, and,
The Scions of the Seventh Dawn, my lord. Good and true friends who opened their hearts and homes to us when we fled to Eorzea. Far across the sea, they have journeyed to stand with us in the fight for Doman liberation, to oppose the Empire, as they have in the West, where they are lauded as heroes for their many deeds.
Say no more, Yugiri. Say no more. I observed how you helped Cyrena, to whom I am deeply indebted. For that, and for the aid you provided my people, you have my deepest gratitude. There is no doubting your strength nor your character. It would be my honor to fight by your side. So, what of Doma? Arise, my friends, and tell me of our home. I have made my decision. Yugiri, I bid you return to Yansha and take charge of our forces in preparation for my homecoming. As for our esteemed guests, I would ask that you remain here with me. I sense you will be a great help in the coming days.
Your will is my command, my lord, but how much longer do you intend to stay?
Oh, only until I have won the contest. I mean to return at the head of Azela army.
You mean to participate in the Nardom?
Have you a better idea? Consider how soundly we were defeated before. The Imperials may have since grown weaker, but we are weaker still. 'Twould be folly to challenge them without first supplementing our forces, so yes, I intend to win the Nardom and enlist the aid of every able-bodied Zayla I can. Furthermore, by championing the Mole in the contest, I can at last repay their kindness. Lest you forget they saved me from certain death, and a man who suffers such debts to go unpaid is without honor and unfit to lead.
Just so. Our lord has spoken, Yugiri. But take heart, I shall keep him safe. And should it come to it, bring him back by force.
This is no laughing matter, Gosetsu. But if these are my orders, very well. Once more, I place my faith in you. Pray look after them both.
Looks like it's up to us then. Though it does seem a bit risky. Isn't Hien meant to be the next king of Doma or something?
So they say. Though in truth, I am but a pale reflection of my late father. All the more reason to entreat your assistance. For ours is an impossible dream. to set in motion a revolution that will rattle the very firmament and shake off the yoke of the most powerful empire in the world. Tamarun Hatun, Cyrena, I am returned.
Ah, you found each other.
Ours is the soil, Hian. The Domans, and the Eorzeans, too.
You know us?
The gods know you, child. as do the stars in the heavens, which shone bright at your coming.
The mole hearken to the whispers of the elder gods, which guide us in our daily lives. We know them through the Utun, like my grandmother.
Hatun, I am come to beg a boon of you and yours. That I might liberate my homeland, I seek to rally the strength of the steppe. To that end, I wish to fight in the Nardom. As a warrior of the Maw, will you grant me this honor?
To stand with the Maw is fruitless. Hian, do not do this. The gods may have willed that our tribe join in the Nardom, but... there is no path to victory. We are weak, and our numbers few. Even with your help, it would be impossible.
I thank you for your concern, Cyrena. But it is precisely because of the seeming hopelessness of your cause that we must needs cast our lot with you. Were we to join hands with a more favored tribe, our victory would inevitably be attributed to them, and no one would follow me to Doma.
T'was the gods' will that we fight. Mayhap this too is their design. Hear me then. As Hatun of the Maw, I invite you all to join with us in the Nardom. Will you look after them?
Come with me, friends. There is much I would show you.
You... wait. I would have words. A singular radiance, shimmering, like a jewel of the Dusk Mother, blinding in its brilliance. Stars flicker and flock to you. Before such gathered light, even the secrets of the gods may be laid bare. Some are fated to rise in grace and glory, others to falter and fade, though not from memory. Both will be your strength and salvation come the end. Cherish the stars and the light they bring you in the dark. For you are a traveler, are you not?
She needed the rest. To come so far and carry so much. Hien and his friend, too. Strange that they should vanish so soon.
Not troubled by your old wounds, I see.
Nor you by yours. I know I should have fled with the others after father died, instead of blindly fighting on. It was reckless and foolish, and there was naught to be gained from it. Everything to lose, rather.
We know no path save the one we walk. I myself am in no hurry to meet those who have gone before. Not while I have still to make amends.
Well said.
You are none the worse for your time in the wilderness. On the contrary, I would say you have improved.
Come now, your victories still far exceed mine. Or have you forgotten all the times you trounced me as a boy?
I feared I would not see you again.
A life so fortuitously saved should be spent wisely. Without regret would I have traded it for our people's amnesty, had it been their will. Instead, they have called for the sword, and so that is what I must be. Until this blade is broken, I can but carve a path forward. Were you truly so concerned for my well-being? You never showed it when I used to spar.
How you cried when you lost, and when your mother tried to comfort you. And when you inevitably came at me once more, swinging your wooden sword wildly. Mina's little Master Shun. What a fine young man you've become.
A man should not be addressed by his childhood name. I've told you about that before. Ah, the mask slips. And I was so close to cultivating a winning persona.
There will be opportunity enough for putting on airs after you have returned in triumph to Doma. Now is the time to show our true character.
Yes, yes. 'Tis a name my parents gave me as a child, but I should like to think I have long since outgrown it. But as you seem determined to bring it back into use, I believe a match is in order. If I win, you will be honor-bound to divulge one of your darkest secrets.